Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to teach you the fastest way to convert your AutoCAD DWG drawings to 3D models in Sketchup. I'm going to import my DWG. It's important to note that this is currently a pro only feature. So if you don't have the trial or SketchUp Pro, you currently can't do that. But I do have a video to show you sort of the workaround to that. So you can check the description below if that's something you're interested in doing. You can see here my DWG imported, super tiny. This looks like a hotel for microorganisms, so we're gonna have to change that. What I'm gonna do is explode this just so that the geometry sort of like settles into SketchUp. I know that sort of sounds weird, but it's what I feel like is happening. And then I'm gonna choose the tape measure tool and measure one of my doorways. Doorways are a pretty good thing to go off of because typically they're a standard size. So this is about 16 inches wide. I don't know many people that could fit through that. So I'm going to change this to 36 inches. It asked me if I want to resize the model. And I'm going to say yes, please. And then choose zoom extents. Delete my guide here that I accidentally created. Zoom in some more. Choose my tape measure tool again just to double check. You can see that this is 3 feet, which is what I have. Now, over on the right hand side, I have my default tray open and the layers flyout is pulled down. And I have these layers that came in. You want to make sure that if you're exporting from AutoCAD, that your layers are sort of set up in a way that makes sense. So there's a lot of like extra stuff in here that I don't need. And I just downloaded this off of a website. So it's in a different language, so I don't actually know what these layers are. So I'm just gonna go through and click on these and see what I don't need. So probably most of these layers I don't need. Looks like that's the money. Moreau is the money one. And that actually has most of the walls on it. It looks like I'm missing a couple of lines there. But you can see when I drew that line, it was completing. Now what happens is like through the layer system in SketchUp is it's still like reading all that information on the other layers, even though I can't see it. So I just want to get rid of it. So what I'm going to do here is just delete each layer. I'm going to select this, and if for whatever reason you're doing this later in the project, you may want to save as, and just make sure you're not deleting anything important, and if you are, that you can re-import it later. So I'm going to delete these contents and then shift click on these four so that I can delete all of them at once. You make sure that you're actually deleting that stuff and not moving it to the home layer. And then I'm going to delete this one, but I'm not actually going to delete it. I'm just going to move it to the default layer. Okay. So I just have a couple little things that I need to clean up, and that's pretty typical with this whole process. There may be some cleanup you have to do, but it's much easier. You can see I already have a few faces, so that's perfect. And now what I want is the rest of these to be faces, but not actually have to draw them. So I'm going to do a little bit of a cheat. I'm going to make this a group. Hit M for move, and then hold the up arrow key to lock to the blue axis so that that's moving vertically. I'm going to hit R to make a rectangle tool, S to scale this and just make it pretty ginormous. You can see what I have here. Select my group that I just made with my plan on it, and then select the drape tool and drape that on the surface I just created. Now what this does is it makes it so that all of those things that I just created are now groups. And I didn't have to like redraw stuff. So if I hit E for the erase tool and just quickly erase, you can see that I have essentially my plan. Now if I hit P for push tool, I can extrude this. Let's say our ceiling height is 8 feet. So I hit 8 feet in there. It extrudes that up 8 feet. Now what I have to do is just double click on all of these and it'll extrude all of these walls up 8 feet. So I only have to do that once. Oops, just zoom extents here. It looks like I have something off to the side. I think that's my scale figure. Zoom extents again. There we go. P, 8 feet. And just double click and it'll extrude all of those 8 feet. So I have a pretty quick layout of the spaces. Now you want to go in and you want to add your doors. So typically doors are 6'8". That's a standard. Come in here. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this little top part for the door, and I'm just going to copy it everywhere that I have a door. Now I'm not like 100% familiar with this project, so I'm going to just assume where some of these doors are. And then you only need to do this on one side of the door. And I'm hitting M for move and then the control key on PC to make a copy. Yeah, so I'm not exactly sure what this is, but I think it's a bathroom. And then what you do with your doors is, because you have all those little lines already and they're at the right height, you can just hit P for the push-pull and then just drag it to where you need it. Obviously, you do the same thing for the windows. If whatever windows are at the same height, you would just draw the bottom. And this helps you like quickly get what you're looking for. And you don't have to go through and like retrace over your plan or anything like that. You just sort of use what you have already drawn and go from there. If there's any sort of cleanup that you need to do, like these extra lines, just hit E for the eraser tool and just click that. And it'll erase those lines. If for whatever reason you click one of those lines and the whole face disappears, maybe you accidentally selected the face, or what you may need to do is just control click, and that will hide the line and not actually delete it. So if I open hidden geometry, you can see that line's there. I don't actually want it there because I don't need it. And so hopefully this helped. If you thought this video was helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. Stop pulling those all-nighters and go to sleep. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.